Come on, Pooch. You can't ride in here. Sorry, boy. Can't go. Thank you.
Doing in here? It looks like this dog brought your baseball glove home.
Gee, Dad, you think we can keep him?
We'll see. He probably belonged to some other boy.
No, Dad. If he did, he'd have a dog tag, and he doesn't. It's only a name plate, see?
Well, it was nice of him to bring your ball glove home anyway.
Hey, who in the world are you two talking to? I didn't hear any... Well, now, that explains it. Say, isn't he a beauty?
Dad, this ain't my ball glove. This is a Pee Wee Reese model. Looks like it's burnt or something.
Bless his heart, he looks starved. Honey, you keep him right here, and I'll go fix him something to eat.
I guess he likes me.
We can keep him, can't we, Dad?
I guess so. I hope we can.
All right, boy, here you are. Come on. Here's your dinner.
That's a boy. Well, that's pretty good, isn't it? Huh?
Look, Ma.
Oh, honey, it's all caked with blood. Well, that's terrible.
It's over here on this one, too.
Yeah, this one, too. Bless his heart. We're going to have to fix you up, aren't we? Yeah.
Must have been a siren. Maybe it hurt his ears. I'll get you another one, boy.
He's been conscious for 15 minutes?
About that long. It's hard to tell. I can't get him to talk.
Does he understand you?
Seems to.
Have you told him yet?
No, I couldn't, Doctor.
I don't know if I can either. Not just yet, anyway. Hi, son. Say, you are a lot better today. You're gonna be a brand new boy in a day or two. You do want to go out and play, don't you? You hear me all right, don't you? Good. There is something I must... They are taking good care of you, aren't they, son? Good. Can you talk? Tell me how old you are. 9? 10? That's it. Now, tell me your full name. That's okay, son. It can wait. Try to get a little sleep, will you?
I have to agree with you, Doctor. It's got to be a mental block. I think the worst sign is that he shows no interest or concern for his parents' death. Now, apparently there's no brain damage. His vision is not impaired. The tests show that.
I'd recommend association with other children. Somehow, we've got to catch his interest and hold it. Make him want to remember. Of course, time is going to be of a great help. We can hope that through a series of tests, we may be able to ferret out something that will give us a clue, put us on the right track.
Enjoyed your lunch, didn't you? You ate most of it.
And you haven't found anything he reacts to?
Not a thing. Those boys in there are all bright, normal children. They've been trying for 3 hours to interest him in all sorts of things. It just hadn't worked.
Well, what about the car? Or where he came from?
Las Cruces, New Mexico.
I wonder if there were any relatives.
Apparently not. The police haven't been able to locate any.
Boy, that's tough. Probably means we're going to have to place him in an orphanage somewhere. Well, maybe we can find a home for him somewhere. In his condition, he's gonna need a lot of love.
Sure gonna need that, all right. Well, we're starting the reaction test today.
Good.
I'll give you a report later on.
Okay, Doctor, fine. Thank you very much.
Lacey May, your family gets bigger each day. Stay away from those rams and you'll quit having lambs. You got too many now anyway.
Son, have I got?
You bet.
Mama, let's go. I'll tell you, Mama. Come on. Come on, here. Come on, Mama.
get up there, Mama.
Come on, atta girl.
Come on, little one. Come on here, atta girl. That's it. Come on. Come on. Come here, I'll help you. Come on, let's go. Atta girl.
Say, you kids, don't you go too far because those black clouds are gonna spit out some water. Okay. Hey, Kulinski! What a shooter that, think ya?
A sheep killer. One more step and he's dead.
Hey, that puppy didn't do you nothing. What a shooter for?
Get out of the way. He's been killing my sheep.
Get the doctor off.
All right,
all right.
You ain't here. Hey, Kulinski, that's my new toy.
Try it. too. Let me have it, boy. Come here, boy. Let me have that glove. Oh, come on, boy. You don't need that old ball glove. Let old Alex have that ball glove. There you are. That's a nice boy. Hey. Come on, bring a couple of buckets over. Not as good as I thought. I know to bring a buck and a half, don't you think?
Thank you. Sitting on that seat after all those meals, doesn't he? I wonder when he sleeps. You know, he must have dropped those bunkers of mine in my face a dozen times last night, every time he heard a siren blow.
I know. I have the same problem. Why do you suppose he decided to take up with us? He's a nice dog, but this lack of sleep is killing me.
Say, I've got an idea. Let's change beds with old Clint and Bob. Then maybe they'll see things our way and we'll send him off to the dog pound.
That sounds pretty good to me.
Thank you. on the wrong engine.
Out of here. New foreman?
Marty, give that a look.
Hey, give me that glove. Mean, eh? Well, I'll knock it out and your teeth with it. Hey, look at that crazy mutt. Look at him. Gone, you crazy mutt. Back out of it.
Hurry.
get a load of this. Looks like the same dog is out the rest of the other day.
Yeah, sure does. Maybe we better get him out of here. If you'll come out, I'd appreciate it.
Okay.
You know I don't tolerate alibis. I want Sir Rex found. That dog is qualified to win the finals, and I'm determined to win. Do you understand? Good. I don't think you realize how much it means to me to have another champion. It means I'll fill that board, that I'll be the first one who's ever won it 5 times. Now, you get going and find that dog. You show up here tomorrow with him by 2 p.m. or just don't show up again. Charlene, get me the chief of police, please.
Yes, Mr. Foster.
Yes, Jim. What's on your mind?
Chief, I've got a major problem. My champion dog, Sir Rex, has disappeared. And tomorrow at 2 p.m., they're having the Grand National Finals. I think I've got an excellent chance of winning, and if I win, I'll be the first one that's ever done it 5 times. Now, anything you can do, you know I'll appreciate. Chief, don't spare the horses. My secretary will give you the description of the dog, and you know I'll appreciate everything.
We'll do everything we can, Jim.
Thank you, Chief.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, Chief. Yes, sir. Gotcha. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Well, what's the scoop?
Chief wants him found. That's about the size of it.
The chief wants him found. How can any dog be that important to a chief of police?
He's a big champion, that's why. And he's owned by Mr. Jim Foster.
The Jim Foster?
Right.
That does it. Dog catchers.
Yep, that's us.
Any of them, Ted?
I've got some old ones over here. Maybe you'd like some of those.
Thank you.
Don't you like any of these either?
Oh, so you like dogs, huh? Well, I'll tell you what, let's just do another one here then.
Dr. Love? It's the dog boy. He shows marked interest in the dog cartoons.
That's wonderful. I'll try to find out right away if he had a dog. That's real fine, Miss Lewis, and be sure to thank Mr. Fuller for me, too.
I will, Doctor. I'm glad you like dogs, Ted. Dr. Lewis thanks you again as usual, Mr. Fuller.
Well, as usual, it's a pleasure, Miss Lewis.
Reach over in the back seat and get my clipboard. We better block off some of the sections we've already covered. Car with us. No wonder we couldn't spot him anywhere. Hey, boy, how did you get so dirty? How did you get so dirty? Quick, roll up your window. That one, too.
Chief of Police, Mr. Foster.
Yes, Chief?
Well, Jim, we found your dog.
You have?
As a matter of fact, he's right here in my office, and it looks like he's taking over.
By George, that's wonderful, Chief. I'll send my driver right over. He'll be there in 30 minutes, and for heaven's sake, please don't let him out of your sight. Oh, and by the way, Chief, come see him win the finals, will you? I'll send you some passes by the driver.
Right, Jim.
I got to get you cleaned up. Don't Mr. Foster get a squint at you.
Yes, sir. Now that I got him scrubbed and brushed. But he was a mess when I brung him in. That's kind of funny, though. He won't do a thing without this old ball glove. I swear, he acts more like a tramp than a champ. Maybe it's the company he's been mixing with.
Could be, Ennis. Could be. Well, I hope that no-count handler shows up in time to show him tomorrow.
Yes, sir. He will, all right. He know what side to butter his bread's on. In the meantime, I've got to glue some hair back on his back. Some has ruffled him up.
Make sure it matches, Ennis. I'm determined to win this show tomorrow.
Don't worry, boss. When I get through with him, he'll shine like a brand new dollar.
Somebody's put a cheap collar on this dog, Ennis. Ennis, I'm out of cigars. Would you mind running down to Brogan's and getting me a box, please?
Yes, sir.
I'll take care of Sir Rex.
Oh, hi, Jim. I hear you found Sir Rex. I'm so happy for you. Sprucing him up a bit, eh, Jim?
Yes, dear, I am. And it's my business, and I'd appreciate it if you'd stay out of it.
I certainly will, but I'm ashamed of you. If you show this dog as Sir Rex, you'll do it alone. It's an unfair thing for you to do, and you know it.
Look, dear, at best it's a wild gamble. I've got a big bet on this show, a really big bet, and I don't intend to lose it by default, no matter what you say. Watch this. Just look at that head. Why, nobody could tell him from Sir Rex, and in some ways he may even be better. Oh, boy, with you, I may win both the blue ribbon and the bet.
As I said, Jim, you'll do it on your own. I'd be ashamed to be seen with you at the dog show.
Good.
You were right, Doctor. We completely saturated that boy with dog pictures. Bob O'Donnell sent over a projector and some films about dogs. I've got to tell you, that boy was completely absorbed.
Isn't that wonderful? That's really encouraging.
Look, see what you think of this. Miss Lewis tells me that they're having the finals in the dog show tomorrow. Of course, there'd be dogs of all different kinds. But if we took him, you know, he could be near him and pet him. I think it'd be the complete release he needs.
It's an excellent idea. As a matter of fact, I know a lot of the dog owners.
Straight to the dog show, Ennis. Well, what are you doing back here? You kind of like me, don't you?
He will not win anyway. By Jove, Governor, what is this, a glove? How about a game with me, old chap?
Me? Oh, me?
I can't stand this mush.
Say, what's all the fuss about?
Let's do the cha-cha,
Promise to game with me.
Gosh, didn't even notice me.
Good luck, champ. I don't think he'll win, eh?
See, I agree.
So long, Poward.
My祖先是黄帝的狗，吃惯Mandarin豆。你的祖先是乞衣的狗，成时吃chop suey。我知道今日梗神我赢，因为我最靓嘅。虽然我唔食过hamburger，但系我肚饿要食。
Fiddle daddle.
I've had it. I'm going to bed.
Oh.
know, some junior.
All right, shake hands.
Congratulations, Jim.
Thank you, Don.
All right, now just one more.
I hope you're right, Don. They've got to find him.
I'm sure they will, Jim.
You're looking for, Ted. You'll find it, honest.
Say, boy, where have you been? Oh, you just came back for your ball club, is that it? Anyway, I'm sure glad to see you.
Doctor! Doctor! This child is ill. He's shaking all over.
Come on, son. We'll get you back to your room in a hurry. Come on, you need to get some rest.
He must have thought it was his dog. I got a glimpse of him as he went over the wall. Take a look, quick! There he goes, down the fire escape!
Don't cry, Ted.
Don't cry, we'll find your dog. I promise you we will. We'll find your dog. Now, don't cry.
You mean to say that was this boy's dog?
Yes, we believe it is, Jim, the way he reacts. Of course, he's unable to speak.
I see.
I'm glad, Jim.
The dog belonged to this little boy, darling. The poor child can't talk. Doctor, do you suppose it might help if we took him to look for the dog? He may feel better doing something about it personally.
I think it definitely might help. Miss Lewis could go with him.
How on earth would you start? I've been thinking about that. The dog reacted twice to sirens. Away he went. I can't imagine why a dog should chase sirens, but it certainly can't hurt us to do the same thing for an hour or so. Son, would you like to go with us and look for your dog?
By the creek and let the boy cool his feet and listen. Is that all right, Miss Lewis?
Yes, I think so.
Is that all right with you, dear?
Just fine. That's the way it's been. And you've seen no improvement? Very little. We have hopes that finding the right dog will trigger the release. We're going to have to take him back pretty soon.
That's the siren at the rock quarry. Ted, boy, Ted! Wait a minute, wait, boy!
He's my dog, Buddy. And we found him just like you said we would.
Yeah, son, we found him. Wasn't exactly the way I meant it. Say, I think I've got a collar that'll fit him. It says Buddy on it. Should we go get it?
Yes, sir. Every dog should have a collar.
You're safe at home.